عليك يا سيدي ومولاي يا رسول الله صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ومولاي وابن مولاي يا أبا عبد الله طبتم وطابت الأرض التي فيها دفنتم ما خاب من تمسك بكم سادتي ومن مثواكم يا ليتنا كنا معكم فنفوز فوزا عظيما الله يا زهرة كم جنازة من بنينك تبقى بلا موارا وشفتيها بعينك والسبب كل من الذي صق جنينك ورث علينا الهضم والحسرات والنوح واحد ثلاثة أيام فوق السطح مطروح وجواده واحد على حمامي الأربعة فوق الجسر ذبوه وكاظمه وما طريح الغاضرية بخيل داسوه وحسينه كم ولد يم حسين برض الطيف مذبوح يا زهراء how many funerals did you witness with your eyes processions with no loved ones to mourn and say their goodbyes it all began at your door where the oppressor killed Muhsin your child after you tragedies upon tragedies upon your children compiled one lay on rooftops for 3 days poisoned under the sun another thrown on the bridge of Baghdad poisoned in a prison slum but how did you witness your beloved Hussein repeatedly crushed on the horse's hooves again and again how many of your children lay slaughtered on those plains Imagine yourself right now in Kazimiya at the shrine of Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam. Imagine you witness a broken woman leaning on his grave. This woman comes to all her children to grieve. Just imagine yourself in her holy presence. May Allah bless you to be a visitor of the Imam. فاطمة البغداد تعنيت مشهدك يا باب المراد تقبل الاعتاب الشوق هجول تشم ريحة ولدها وصوتها يقول يا ابني شلون افقدك يا ابني معقول وانت وحدك ممرود الافاد آه 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 فوق عتارة صارت تارها تقوم تونم من الضلع والصدور مهشوم تقل جيت أزورنك يا مسموم وأنا المتعود أقصد كل الأولاد تقل يا ابني زيدت آلام عمري ولهذا الوقت مألوم صدري لكن ساعد الله عليك صبري أنا ركن الهدام والحزن زاد With the visitors Fatima came to Baghdad She came to visit with the Shia Bab al-Murad The gate of desire She kisses your grave and breathes in your scent Pacing with grief as we all lament Saying my dear son how did I lose you as well Lonely in Baghdad with no aid you fell Her state is tragic she walks a few steps and stumbles Her state is tragic She walks a few steps and stumbles She places her hand on her chest in pain She's humbled Though her ribs are broken She says I still came my dear child I see all my children as their tragedies compiled لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم يقول الله في محكم كتابه العزيز الحكيم في سورة الملك بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذي خلق الحياة والموت ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور صدق الله العلي العظيم Allah says he who has created death as well as life so that he might put you to a test and thus show which of you is best in conduct and make you realize he alone is almighty truly forgiving. This ayah from Surah Al-Mulk illustrates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created life and death in order to test His creation with trials and tribulations to see who can handle them and who is best in conduct. And these trials did not exclude the prophets and imams. Where a man tells Imam Al-Baqir alayhi salam, by Allah, I love you Ahl al-Bayt. The imam replied, then be dressed with bala trials like a jilbab, a gown. By Allah, it approaches us like a flood in a valley. When we study Islamic history, we observe that the age of Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam was a great bala or affliction to the Shia who followed Ahlul Bayt. Imam al-Jawad receiving imamat at 7 years of age was faced with many questions and skepticism from both great Shia companions such as his uncle Abdullah son of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam and also from the established tyrannical government of Banu Abbas. You had Al-Ma'mun anallah who poisoned Imam al-Rida alayhi salam and forcefully married Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam to his daughter al-Fadl who was always jealous of his other pious wife mother of Imam al-Hadi salamullahi alayhi. After the demise of Al-Ma'mun, his brother Al-Mu'tasim ascended to the throne. He carried great enmity and hatred for Ahlul Bayt, especially Imam Al-Jawad alayhi salam and his Shia. He would constantly publicly persecute them and oppress them. Al-Fadl would always complain to her father Al-Ma'mun about the Imam, but he rejected her letters. However, her uncle Al-Mu'tasim had a soft spot for her. So when he came into power, he concocted a poison and sent it to her to give to her husband, the Imam. Let us go to the scene. Imagine yourself there. Let your aching hearts guide your vision to this tragic scene. Al-Fadl an Allah chose a summer day that was extremely hot. The Imam was fasting. The first thing she gave the imam to break his fast on was poison yogurt. Imagine yourself all day fasting in extreme summer heat. What would you ask for? A cold drink of water to quench your thirst. But the first thing to quench the imam's thirst was poison. What did the imam feel? He immediately felt the heat and strength of the poison as it tore his insides. What did Umm al-Fadl do? She locked all the doors and windows so the imam feels the heat outside and inside his body. The imam was not able to feel not one cool breeze, at least. The imam, feeling his body burning, what did he do? He began to use the last energy he had to crawl, dragging himself with difficulty until he reached the rooftop of his house. But what is there for him on the rooftop? The heat of the sun blazing. As if I could imagine the imam at this time tossing and turning as he cries of as the cries of pain are silenced by the strength of the poison. When his time approached, his forehead began sweating. His groans were quiet. He stretched out his arms and legs. He closed his eyes. His breaths were no more. His head tilted and his pure soul departed. Wa imama wa sayyida wa musibata. The imam's body remained on the roof for 3 days without washing or shrouding as the sun scorched his body. Just like his grandfather Abu Abdullah. After 3 days, how did the people know where the imam's body lay? They saw birds in flocks hovering above the roof, and the smell of musk scented the air. They climbed up and found the imam in his state. They began to cry out to our imam, Sayyida wa madluma. Imam al-Hadi salamullahi alayhi arrived, took the body of his father, washed and shrouded him, and prepared him for burial. He comes with tears flowing like a river, embraces his father, crying out, Aghwa alayhi sayh, wadmu'a sachiba. شلون الحبيب يروح ويفارق حبيبه يا بويا والله موحش الدنيا عليا والله عليا بديار الغربة مجرع سموم المنية بلغ سلام المصطفى خير البرية والله بلغ سلامي لأمي فاطمة الزهرة الزكية. He lay on his father drenched in tears of sorrow. He said, how can a loved one be here one day and leave his loved ones tomorrow? Father, this world is empty without you around. You've been taken by poison, a stranger to this town. Send my greetings to my grandfather, the best of creations, Al-Mustafa. Send my greetings to our broken mother, فاطمة الزغراء. بس يا مولاي الغادي, you were able to witness your father through his inside, though his insides were torn. His outer appearance you could take in, but what did Imam al-Sajjan take in when he came to bury his father Hussein? They tore his body to pieces. His stab wound was stopped with another stab wound until there was no part of his holy body that was unharmed. His bones were crushed by the Awajiya horses his holy had removed when he placed what was left of the Imam in the grave. He leaned over, placed his cheek on the severed neck and said, Aba, inna dunya ba'daka muzlima والآخرة بنور وجهك مشرقة أما الليل فسف مسجد والحزن سرمد. Father, this world after you is dark and the hereafter shines from the glow of your face. The nights are sleepless and my sorrow is eternal. But طوف حسين جدة تغسل بفيض الدماء, جنازته ظلت رمية بالخيول مردردة. إن كربلاء الجواد's grandfather's body was washed with his blood. His funeral was on the horse's hoof that stampeded like a flood. إمام زين العابدين لم جميع وصال أبو الانكسر والانهشام حتى قطعت قلب اللي استخرجوها بالسهم. شالوا نزل بقبره والدمع يهم. He picked up his father's pieces, some broken, some torn. Even the piece of his heart on that he took out like a thorn, and his ring finger that was cut. Ali in tears as he mourns, he placed his father in the grave. Imam Zainul Abidin witnessed Imam al-Hussein in this state. But in what state did he witness another Zainab? يقول أنا ما نكست رأسي لجل ذبح الصناديد, ما قصر وبالغاضرية زلزل البيد. أنا نكس الرأسي يدخلون زينب المجلس يزيد. كيف دخلت زينب المجلس؟ تقول بس هاي ما كانت على البال, أطب المجلس وبزنود الحبال. السجاد يقول طبين المجلس والله بيا حال, أنا الجامع بصدري ومجتوف النساء والأطفال. فعل يزيد ما أنسى وما أنسى ديوانه, جدام النساء والأطفال تناول رأس مولانا. I did not lower my head when they slaughtered my loved ones and I watched them bleed. What broke me is when they forced my auntie Zainab to entertain the courts of Yazid. How did Zainab enter? As if I can hear say, out of all the tragedies I never thought this would happen to me. Dragged like a slave, tied in front of strange men as they cursed my father Ali. As Sajjad says, with a collar on my neck, we entered in a dreadful state. Women and children chained while we watched them put my father Hussein's head on a plate. I will never forget what Yazid did on that cursed day. He lifted my father's head by his gray hair and began to poke and play. In plain sight of the women and children and my eyes, do you understand why now for the rest of my days I cried? إن لله وإنا إليه راجعون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون والعاقبة للمتقين. يا كاشف السوء اكشف السوء عنا يا الله. اللهم شافي كل مريض بحق مريض كربلاء الإمام زين العابدين سلام الله عليه. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين بحق باب المراد الإمام التقي الجواد. اللهم فك أسرانا وانصر مجاهدينا. اللهم ارحم موتانا على روح أمواتنا ولروح أمواتنا وأمواتكم. رحم الله من قرأ السورة المباركة الفاتحة مع الصلوات.